guys, what's up? New tutorial demo. As you have heard today, we are seeing a more emotive demo compared to the others. In this demo, I used two tracks of True Legato, Elven True Legato, and the Romantic True Legato, and some vocal phrases. Let's take a closer look. Well, in the first part, there is this Elven vocal phrase. I'm using a lot of black hole to put this vocal on the back, and I'm using Berling Studio to add more room, additional room. And as usual, Pro Q3 and the Sooth. On the True Legato part, this one, I'm using Berling Studio with the choir setting, with just a little bit of Decca and the surround mix. Then a Pro Q3 EQ just to control this area with a dynamic compressor, with a dynamic EQ. A little bit of a sooth and a compressor, this Teletronics, which is a soft compressor, you know, and it's work very well with the voices. Then we have other vocal phrases here together with the True Legato. I would like to explain this part because it's a part where there are a lot of vocals together. So we have the True Legato with the Romantic True Legato. I'm using a strong compression here to, because this vocal is in a low range, so I need of a big compression to have this part in a right position into the mix, you know. For this reason, I'm pushing with the compressor, and I'm using sooth as usual. And then there are some parts with these vocal phrases. With a lot of reverb. Of course, when there are all the tracks, this reverberation is less perceptible, but it's useful to have this ethereal sound. And I'm using different vocal phrases because, for example, I'm using the offset with the vocal phrase to select which part of each phrase I want to use. Created this puzzle with using a selection of a phrase, another selection of another phrase. So this is also a way to use the vocal phrase because you have the offset, you can select different part. I hope it's clear what I mean as usual. That's all about the vocal. That's all. Then there are this part with the strings. And in this case, I'm using just Berling Studio. About the mastering, as usual, I'm using my Brainworks to fix some frequencies, you know. No, this one, this one. Then I'm using a compressor, Erin by Acoustic Audio, but in this part is not working. It works only when there are more content, more tracks. Then a bit of Celestial Mastering Edition. I'm using just a little bit of texture and dimension. Then a Pro Q3 with these settings. Another one with just this fix. And Ash. So this is another example of what you can do with Ephera Gold, Atlantis, plus of course some orchestral sound. The strings are from Cinematic Studio Strings, and I'm using separate sections, and there is a part with a Gran Cassa by Elements Cinematic Rhythms, and a part with solo French horn by Nucleus, and that's all. Okay, I'm using a tempo track here just to create a little bit of nice feeling, a nice flow, you know. Let's see again here. On the string I created a little bit of automation with the faders, with the fader, sorry, but also with the modulation wheel. A little bit of tempo track variation. Thank you. about the true legato, one more thing. I'm using the, of course, as usual, the track delay to compensate the latency, you know. But I'm not quantizing any notes. For example, let me show you here. So you can see, for example, this note is quantized, but in this case, I create a little bit of shifting, a little bit of shift. Also in this part, a little bit here, just to have a bit of a humanized effect, you know? Also in this case. That's all. I hope this tutorial it was helpful, and see you in the next video. Ciao.